In this video, we'll look at how to get started using the DevExpress Blazor ComboBox. A combo box displays a drop-down window with a list of items. Let's look at how to add a combo box and customize it. I've already created a Blazor application that's configured to use DevExpress components. The @code block contains declarations for sample data. The type person includes a set of properties, ID, first name, last name, and so on. The staff class has a data source method that retrieves a list of demo objects. Now I add a DxComboBox to the page and set the data property to bind the combo box to the data source. I also specify the @bindValue attribute to bind the editor value to the selected person field. Let's take a look at this in the browser. The combo box's drop-down window displays a list of predefined items. When a user selects a value from the list, the edit box displays the selected value. You can also allow users to type values into the edit box. I go back to Visual Studio and set the allow user input property to true. Now I can enter any text to the editor. I can also specify the editor's text in code. I create the text field and use the @bind attribute to bind the editor's text property to the text field. The combo box initially displays the specified text. You can also specify if the clear button is displayed in the editor when it is not empty, and specify a prompt text that is displayed in the editor when its value is null. Let's view the changes. The combo box component allows you to dynamically filter list items based on the text typed into the editor. I use the filtering mode property to enable filtering and specify the filter mode, contains. I can type text into the editor to filter list items that contain this string. Now, let me demonstrate how to change the width of the combo box's drop-down list. Currently, the list width matches the editor. To change the width, I set the drop-down width mode property to content width. The combo box also allows you to specify the direction in which the drop-down window is displayed relative to the input element. The default value is down. Let's change it to up. And take a look at this in the browser. As you can see, the list width is equal to the width of the longest list item. However, the drop-down window is still displayed below the input. This happens because the component is close to the top edge of the browser window, and there isn't enough space to display the drop-down window in the up direction. To demonstrate the up direction, I need to place the component further from the top edge. I'll add the calendar component before the combo box. And now the drop-down list is displayed up into the calendar area. And that's it for this video. If you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.